Good evening, the internet. Welcome to Geeks Who Drink. It's me, Eric the Jewish Viking. I know it's been like a year or something. Hello, how's everyone doing? I know, surprise holiday hosting from Eric. Yes, holy shit, even Geeks Who Drink didn't know I was going to be hosting tonight. It is me! Hello. Hello, chat friends. How are you? I know, it has been a long time. Penelope is somewhere in the house. She is her own dog and comes and goes as she pleases. That's how this works. Well, I hope you guys are ready for quiz. I didn't practice anything, so let's see how rusty I am and get started right with round number one. Round one, the theme of round one tonight. 41 years ago. It's the 100th anniversary of the Lincoln Memorial, so we've got an entire round on Honest Abe. Question number one. Number one. He was born on February 12th, 1809, the exact same date as what finch-sketching, beagle-riding evolutionary biologist? Number one. He was born on February 12th, 1809, the exact same date as what finch-sketching, beagle-riding evolutionary biologist? Question number two. Number two. Raised in Indiana and Kentucky, he was 21 before he lived in what state that now calls itself the Land of Lincoln? Number two. Raised in Indiana and Kentucky, he was 21 before he lived in what state that now calls itself the Land of Lincoln? Question number three. Number three. Though he probably never delivered any tombstone pile drivers, he was a county champion in what sport? Number three. Though he probably never delivered any tombstone pile drivers, he was a county champion in what sport? Jerfed is not wrong about Murica. It's not wrong about Murica. Number four. Question four. In our round on Abe Lincoln, two men have received Oscar nominations for portraying Abe: Raymond Massey, who lost, and what not American method actor who won? Question four. Two men have received Oscar nominations for portraying Lincoln: Raymond Massey, who lost, and what not American method actor who won? Jerfad is pretty sure that Abe Lincoln had at least 14 tombstones. I don't know what to compare that to. Number five. No peeking, yes or no, is he wearing a tie in the current $5 bill image? No checking, all of you young people who still carry cash around at any given moment. Yes or no, is he wearing a tie in the current $5 bill image? Round one, 4 score and 1 score years ago. We're on question six. Number six. He turned down Siamese ruler Mongkut's offer to send America some elephants. Mongkut later became a character in what Broadway musical? There's one thing about Geeks Who Drink. We're always going to have a question about a Broadway musical. He turned down Siamese ruler Mongkut's offer to send America some elephants. Mongkut later became a character in what Broadway musical? Question number seven, penultimate question. Number seven. When he said his explanations explanatory of explanations explained are interminable, he was dissing what pint-sized debater? Number seven. When he said, quote, his explanations explanatory of explanations explained are interminable, he was dissing what pint-sized debater? And the last question of round one, question number eight. Number eight. While serving as Secretary of War, his son Robert witnessed the shooting of what other president who naturally died on a Monday? Number eight, one more time. While serving as Secretary of War, his son Robert witnessed the shooting of what other president who naturally died on a Monday? Great Gabo, you don't not know that Solomon Grundy was not necessarily a president. All right, it's the end of round one. That means it's time for our first bonus question of the evening. Bonus questions. You can win yourself up to $50 in Taver credit for correctly answering the question. And, of course, the system not being rigged in anyone else's favor. Exclamation point in the answer in chat. Here's your bonus question. Daniel Chester French's statues of Lincoln can be found in the Lincoln Memorial and, fittingly, in what state's Capitol building? Exclamation point and the answer in chat. If you win, you'll get $5 in Taver credit and a chance at the end of the night to hopefully bump that up to $50. Bonus question. Daniel Chester French's statues of Lincoln can be found in the Lincoln Memorial and, fittingly, in what state's Capitol building? All right, let's go over some answers. Answers to round one. Question one. There it is, those answers. He was born on February 12th, 1809, the exact same date as what fidget-sketching, beagle-riding evolutionary biologist? That is, of course, Charles Darwin. Number two, raised in Indiana and Kentucky. He was 21 before he lived in what state that now calls itself the Land of Lincoln? And of course, Illinois. Though he probably never delivered any tombstone pile drivers, he was a county champion in what sport? I think Jerfad probably got this one correctly. The answer is wrestling. Abe Lincoln was a wrestler. He wrestled things. Like The Undertaker. Number four. Two men have received Oscar nominations for portraying Abe, Raymond Massey, who lost, and what not-American method actor who won? And of course, Daniel Day-Lewis. He was amazing when he portrayed Lincoln using only his feet. Question number five. Yes or no, is he wearing a tie in the current $5 bill image? Yes! The answer's yes. I don't have a joke for that one. Number six, he turned down Siamese ruler Mongkut's offer to send America some elephants. Mongkut later became a character in what Broadway musical? That musical, The King and I. Penultimate question, number seven. When he said his explanations, explanatory of explanations explained, are interminable, he was dissing what pint-sized debater? That is Stephen Douglas. And the last question, number eight. While serving as Secretary of War, his son Robert witnessed the shooting of what other president, who naturally died on a Monday? That was James Garfield. And if you guys are interested in presidential assassinations, I cannot highly recommend Sarah Vowell's book, Assassination Vacation, enough. It is amazing. I love that book. Some of you, I assume, read. Back to the round one bonus question. Your bonus question. Daniel Chester French's statues of Lincoln can be found in the Lincoln Memorial and fittingly in what state's Capitol building? That is Nebraska. Someone in chat said, go cornholes. I assume that's something to do with Nebraska. Or they've been on other parts of the internet and just want to share how excited they are. No one really likes cornholing. Unless it's on the internet. Round two. It's our music round, of course. The theme of round two, our music round this evening, is Susu Studio. It's National Creativity Day. And each clip in this round is going to feature two songs whose similarity is totally coincidental. Totally. 100% totally coincidental. We're not looking for name titles this round. If you know the title of a song, great. Good for you. You're great. And I love you. But we only want for points both artists' names. All right. So if you know the song titles, great. We don't give a shit tonight. We're just looking for both artists in each clip. Here we go.
And if there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it.
Ice, ice, baby.
Okay.
Tipping around, keep my brains on the floor. These are the days, it never rains, but it pours.
Remember when you swore to God I was the only person who ever got. Well, screw that, and screw you. You will never have to hurt the way you know that I do. Whoa, whatever makes it break. But I got it where I want it.
Grab on my waist and put that body on me. I'm coming now, follow my lead. I'm coming now, follow my lead.
No, I don't want your number, no. I don't wanna give you mine, and no, I don't wanna meet you nowhere, no. Don't wanna name your time, and no.
If you're seeing things running through your head, who can you call?
Ghostbusters!
I want a new job, one that won't go away. One that won't keep me up all night. One that won't make me sleep all day.
I don't want you to leave, will you hold my hand? Oh, won't you stay with me?
No, I won't back down. You can stand me up at the gates of hell, but I won't back down.
And if there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it.
Ice, ice, baby.
Okay.
Tipping around, keep my brain on the floor. These are the days, it never ends, but it falls.
Remember when you swore to God I was the only person who ever got you? Well, screw that, screw you. You will never have to hurt the way you know that I do. Whatever makes you break, but I got it where I want it now. Well, it was never my intention to break.
Grab on my waist and put that body on me. I'm coming now, follow my lead. I'm coming now, follow my lead.
I don't wanna give you mine, and no, I don't wanna meet you nowhere, no. Don't wanna name your time, and no.
If you're seeing things running through your head, who can you call?
Ghostbusters!
I want a new job.
I don't want you to leave, will you hold my hand? Oh, won't you stay with me?
No, I won't back down. You can stand me up at the gates of hell, but I won't back down.
My sweet Lord,
I check it once, then I check it twice. Oh!
I'm too sexy for my shirt. Too sexy for my shirt. So sexy it hurts.
All right, that's the end of round two. We're going to take a quick little break. You can go get a drink. You can urinate on your best friend or roommate. You can cornhole it up. A lot of people in chat really interested in that tonight. I don't know why. I still don't understand the appeal of it, but, you know, you do whatever you want. Hello, everyone. We're back with some more Geeks Who Drink here on the internet. The chat is still on cornholes. That's still cornholing it up. All right. Round two. It's time for some answers.
Ice, ice, baby. Okay.
Vanilla Ice and Queen with David Bowie. Number two. Olivia Rodrigo and Paramore. Question three. It was Ed Sheeran and TLC. Ray Parker Jr. and Huey Lewis and the News. Number five. Sam Smith and Tom Petty. Mariah Carey and The Emotions. Penultimate song time. George Harrison and The Chiffons. Lastly, number eight. Taylor Swift and Right Said Fred.
Too sexy for my shirt. Too sexy for my
shirt. How'd everyone doing in that music round? With double the songs. Exceedingly well, I hope. Or just don't say anything. Hey, we got 14 points from someone. And 11 out of 16, which is the best we can get from the Great Gobble. On to round three. The theme of round three tonight is, can I start you off with a glass of red ink? Can I start you off with a glass of red ink? It is a multiple choice round on editors and restaurants. That's right. Round three, multiple choice round. Thanks for subscribing, Epoch Demon, for 20 months. 20 months. That's only 3 months shy of my record. Question number one. Number one. Elle Magazine editor-in-chief Nina Garcia is a judge on what reality competition? America's Next Top Model or Project Runway? Elle Magazine editor-in-chief Nina Garcia is a judge on what reality competition? America's Next Top Model or Project Runway? Question number two. Number two. Which one is a memoir of Anthony Bourdain's life as a chef? Devil in the Kitchen or Kitchen Confidential? Number two. Which one is a memoir of Anthony Bourdain's life as a chef? Devil in the Kitchen or Kitchen Confidential? Anthony Bourdain, who my mother is very vocal about having a crush on, even though he's dead. And he made smoking look cool. Sorry, that's just the way it is. Children, don't smoke. Round three, question three. Number three. What film won the most recent Oscar for Best Film Editing? Dune or West Side Story? Number three, what film won the most recent Oscar for Best Film Editing? Dune or West Side Story? Let's look at the chat. Oh, the chat is filled with puns now. This is great. Gaba pointing out El Magazine is Spanish for The Magazine. Round three. Can I start you off with a glass of red ink? A multiple choice round on editors and restaurants that doesn't have anything to do with cock-ups or rhymes at all. Question number four. Number four. What's the name of the fancy French place in Pixar's Ratatouille? Antoine's or Gusteau's? Number four. What's the name of the fancy French place in Pixar's Ratatouille? Antoine's or Gusteau's? Time for question number five. Question five. What famous abolitionist edited an anti-slavery newspaper called The North Star? Frederick Douglass or Harriet Tubman? Number five. What famous abolitionist edited an anti-slavery newspaper called The North Star? Frederick Douglass or Harriet Tubman? Question number six in our third round of the night. Number six. Often ranked the best restaurant in the world, Noma is in what country? Denmark or Japan? Number six. Often ranked the best restaurant in the world, Noma is in what country? Denmark or Japan? Moving right along, penultimate question time, number seven. Question seven. What literary word is the P in the gene editing technique CRISPR? Palindromic or protagonist? Number seven. What literary word is the P in the gene editing technique CRISPR? Palindromic or protagonist? Also, if you want to piss off an English instructor, call it protagonist. And the last question of the round, question number eight. Number eight, the current season of Top Chef was filmed in what city, Dallas or Houston? Number eight, the current season of Top Chef was shot in what city, Dallas or Houston? We'll be right back. All right. I hope you guys are ready because it's time for our next bonus question, in which you too can win up to $50 in Taver credit if the odds are rigged in your favor. All you have to do is type in exclamation point and the answer in the chat and then pray to a god of your choosing really hard. And then AJ's just going to do what he wants anyway behind the scenes. Bonus question. In a Microsoft Word edit menu, Control Z is undo and Control Y is what? Exclamation point and the answer in the chat. In a Microsoft Word edit menu, Control Z is undo and Control Y is what? All right, let's get into some answers for our third round. Round three, of course, being can I start you off with a glass of red ink, our multiple choice round on editors and restaurants. Here's number one. Elle Magazine editor-in-chief Nina Garcia is a judge on what reality competition, America's Next Top Model or Project Runway? The answer is, of course, Project Runway. The show I've definitely watched. Number two. Which one is a memoir of Anthony Bourdain's life as a chef, Devil in the Kitchen, or Kitchen Confidential? That one is Kitchen Confidential. Number three. What film won the most recent Oscar for Best Film Editing, Dune or West Side Story? That was Dune. Dune. West Side Story wasn't even nominated. They weren't even nominated. They weren't even cool enough. They don't even go to this school. Number four. The name of the fancy French place in Pixar's Ratatouille, Antoine's, or Gusteau's? The answer is Gusteau's. Question five. Number five, what famous abolitionist edited an anti-slavery newspaper called the North Star? Was it Frederick Douglass or Harriet Tubman? That was Frederick Douglass. Number six, often ranked best restaurant in the world, Noma is in what country, Denmark or Japan? The answer, Denmark. Something delicious is in Denmark, and it's at Noma. Number seven. What literary word is the P in the gene editing technique CRISPR, palindromic, or protagonist? Protagonist. The answer, of course, palindromic. I mean, who doesn't know that one? Palindromic. And the last question, question eight. Current season of Top Chef. It was shot in what city? Dallas or Houston? Houston. Where the Top Chefs go? To Houston. Back to the round three bonus question. Bonus question. In a Microsoft Word edit menu, Control Z is undo and Control Y is redo. And that's a key combination I never remember exists at all. Just, I grew up using MS-DOS. If you fuck up, you fuck up. That's it. Just start over from the beginning. The theme of round four tonight is courts, ships, and courtship. Courtships and courtship. Yes, you guessed it, around on courts, boats, and animal romance rituals. Animal romance rituals. Question number one. The first case ever docketed with the U.S. Supreme Court involved a loan given to the state of Maryland in what war? Number one. The first case ever docketed with the U.S. Supreme Court involved a loan given to the state of Maryland in what war? Question number two. Number two. It's question number two for a reason. What do you call a partial deck of a ship that forms the roof of a cabin at the stern? Boat questions. What do you call a partial deck of a ship that forms the roof of a cabin at the stern? Round four, courtships and courtship. We're on question three. Number three. Straight up yes or no, do we actually have any documentation of female praying mantises chomping the heads off of males post-courtship? Straight up yes or no on this one. Do we actually have any documentation of female praying mantises chomping the heads off of males post-courtship? And when I say post-courtship, I mean, you know what I mean. Round four, question number four. Number four. Emma Stone starts her rise to power in the kitchens of England's historic Hampton Court Palace in what 2018 film? Number four. Emma Stone starts her rise to power in the kitchens of England's historic Hampton Court Palace in what 2018 film? Courtships and courtship, question number five. Number five, back to Maryland. The midshipmen are the sports team of what school with a $0 tuition? Number five, back to Maryland. The midshipmen are the sports teams of what school with a $0 tuition? Keeping it moving, we're on to question number six of our fourth round. Question six. After a color-shifting courtship dance, males blow water through their trunks to show that their egg pouches are empty. What animals are those? Number six, after a color-shifting courtship dance, males blow water through their trunks to show that their egg pouches are empty. What animals are those? And you know what? For funsies, tell me in the chat, what song was playing throughout that courtship dance? Just take a guess. What dance, what song would you like to hear if you were doing a color-shifting courtship dance and about to blow water through your trunks to show that you have an empty egg pouch? Ah, Chumbawamba. Yeah, that's a good one. I definitely appreciate it when I ask the chat to do something and it's the quietest the chat's been the whole night. Thank you, chat. Question number seven. Number seven. On the court at the 2022 NBA All-Star Game, Team LeBron beat the team helmed by what easy money sniper of the Brooklyn Nets? That's right. Sport. On the court at the 2022 NBA All-Star Game, Team LeBron beat the team helmed by what easy money sniper of the Brooklyn Nets? Oh man, Great Gabo wrote in, I get knocked up, but I get up again.
It's good.
It's good. And the last question, question eight. Number eight. In Jinja, Uganda, you can take a cruise on one of the original boats used in what 1951 Bogart film? Number eight. One more time. In Jinja, Uganda, you can take a cruise on one of the original boats used in what 1951 Bogart film? All right, that's the end of round four. That means it's time for another bonus question and another opportunity for the system to be rigged in your favor to win potentially up to $50 in Taver credit. All you have to do is type in exclamation point in the answer and wish really hard. Or cash app money to AJ. Either works. Here's your bonus question. Featuring period costumes and horseback riding dates, the goofy dating show Courtship is partially inspired by what Netflix Shondaland hit? Your bonus question. Featuring period costumes and horseback riding dates, the goofy dating show Courtship is partially inspired by what Netflix Shondaland hit? All right, let's go back and do some answers for round four. Round four, of course, courtships and courtships. A round that included animal romance rituals and no questions on the Bloodhound Gang. I feel that was an opportunity missed. Question one. The first case ever docketed with the U.S. Supreme Court involved a loan given to the state of Maryland in what war? That was the American Revolution. Number two. It's question number two for a reason. What do you call a partial deck of a ship that forms the roof of a cabin at the stern? That is, of course, the poop deck. And if your poop deck is large enough, you can cornhole on it. Question number three. Straight up yes or no on this one. Do we actually have any documentation of female praying mantises chomping the heads off of males post-courtship? Yes! Yes, we do! They're not very fast animals. We can film them. We've filmed them. It's on the internet. Question number next one. Emma Stone starts her rise to power in the kitchens of England's historic Hampton Court Palace in what 2018 film? That is The Favourite. The Favourite with a U. That's how you know it's foreign and better than us. Just how it works. Question number five. Back to Maryland, the midshipmen are the sports teams of what school with a $0 tuition? And that is the U.S. Naval Academy. Prof. MDM says, cornholing on the poop deck is my favorite episode of Our Flag Means Death. I'm only a couple episodes into it. I'm behind on the times. Round four, question number six. After a color-shifting courtship dance, males blow water through their trunks to show that their egg pouches are empty. What animals are those? They are seahorses. Seahorses found way below the poop deck. Number seven. On the court at the 2022 NBA All-Star Game, Team LeBron beat the team helmed by what easy money sniper of the Brooklyn Nets? That is Kevin Durant. And the last question of the round, question number eight. In Jinja, Uganda, you can take a cruise on one of the original boats used in what 1951 Bogart film? That is The African Queen. The African Queen, which a couple years ago got an amazing restoration on Blu-ray. Highly recommend it if you like that movie. Back to the bonus question. Bonus question time. Featuring period costumes and horseback riding dates, the goofy dating show Courtship is partially inspired by what Netflix Shondaland hit? That is Bridgerton. Bridgerton. Shout out to my brother, who does sound on the show. He's a foley artist in Hollywood, and he did the foley on Bridgerton. So every time people are having sex and there's smacking sounds, my brother did
that. Yeah, we all know what sound he does, Eric. We all know.
I assume he does other sounds. That's the only one I want to call out. Round five is our video round. And I don't remember what it is, so just hit play.
Yummy, yummy, yummy.
The Devil Wears Prego. We've always forgotten the differences between haute couture and haute cuisine. Anyway, name these movies where someone wears some food.
Miss Hiller? The water's boiling.
Hello! Ah! Oh, I'm sorry to frighten you, dear. I must look like a yeti in this getup. This is my nightly meringue mask, part of my beauty regimen. What it is basically egg white.
You do not want to get into that, man. Too much drama.
Yeah.
What is going on here? Look at this!
So warm in 1 minute, you're cold. And...
Oh.
things I've seen.
Oh, wow, a police chase!
Where are your manners?
Oh, sod my manners, you old trout. This is the first fun I've had in weeks.
My lord.
Let me...
Sam,
I'm not gonna let you go. Flint, you'll be stuck down there.
It's not ideal, no.
Come with us. We'll start over. We'll live underground. Use bacon for clothes.
Sam, that's not a very good plan.
Miss Helen? The water's boiling.
Hello! Oh, I'm sorry to frighten you, dear. I must look like a yeti in this getup. This is my nightly meringue mask, part of my beauty regimen. What it is basically egg white.
I am so sorry.
You do not want to get into that, man. Too much drama.
Yeah.
What is going on here?
Look at this! So warm, and one minute you're cold, and all... Of all the Evelyns I've seen...
Oh, wow, a police chase!
Where are your manners?
Oh, sod my manners, you old trout. This is the first fun I've had in weeks.
My lord.
Let me...
Sam,
I'm not gonna let you go. Flint, you'll be stuck down there.
It's not ideal, no.
Come with us.
All right, that's the end of round number five. We're gonna take another break. Come back in just a minute or so with the answers to round five, and then we'll move on to the remainder of quiz. Penelope still isn't here. She doesn't want to hang out. She's not an influencer like I thought she was when she was a puppy. But we'll see if we could coax her out before the end of the quiz. We'll be right back. All right, we are back with more quiz, and we are joined by a new friend. It's Penelope. And she needs a treat. Hold on. She is not making it easy for the camera. We'll give her another treat in a minute. Let's do answers to round five. And we'll have the dog cam going. Dog time. That was Penelope ASMR. Hooray. We're on to round number six. And she slobbered all over the microphone. It's not coming off. Round six. The theme of round six tonight is it's not TV, it's HBO. Here's how this round is going to work. There are two-part questions, one not about TV and one about HBO. You need to answer both parts for 1 point apiece. All right, two-part questions, one not about TV, one about HBO. Answer both of them for all the points. Question number one. Number one, a famous historical example of food insecurity was what island's 1840s potato famine? And the second part, who co-created and starred in HBO's Insecure? Both of those questions again. A famous historical example of food insecurity was what island's 1840s potato famine, and who co-created and starred in HBO's Insecure? Fun fact, my microphone now smells like fish treats because I pushed the microphone too close to Penelope's mouth and fish bits got caught in the microphone. This is going to be fun. Number two. Barry Bonds ended his career 65 hits shy of what milestone number? And for the second point, in Barry, Bill Hader plays a hitman living in LA and trying to convert to what legit job? Barry Bonds ended his career 65 hits shy of what milestone number? And in Barry, Bill Hader plays a hitman living in LA and trying to convert to what legit job? Round six, it's not TV, it's HBO. We're on question number three. Number three. The first book and first film adaptation of the Oz series was called The What Wizard of Oz? And secondly, what Ghostbuster played the warden on Oz? Number three. The first book and first film adaptation of the Oz series was called The What Wizard of Oz? And what Ghostbuster played the warden on Oz? Question number four. Number four. Nicknamed Le Roi Soleil, what long-lived king was succeeded by his great-grandson? And secondly, the Roy family on Succession is led by what long-lived patriarch? Number four. Nicknamed Le Roi Soleil, what long-lived king was succeeded by his great-grandson? And the Roy family on Succession is led by what long-lived patriarch? Round six, it's not TV, it's HBO. Two-part questions, one not about TV, one about HBO. We're on question five. Number five, what Philadelphia University is the home of the Dragons? Secondly, the upcoming House of the Dragon is about what inbred Westerosi family? Number five, what Philadelphia University is home of the Dragons? And the upcoming House of the Dragon is about what inbred Westerosi family? Question number six of round six. Number six. One of the most famous opera roles for soprano Leontine Price was what Ethiopian princess? And secondly, on The Sopranos, which character owned and operated the Bada Bing strip club? It's all question six. One of the most famous opera roles for soprano Leontine Price was what Ethiopian princess? And on The Sopranos, which character owned and operated the Bada Bing strip club? penultimate question time for round six. That's right, question number seven. First part of question seven. The White Lotus sect of 12th century China practiced what religion? And secondly, the White Lotus is set at a resort in what state? It's all question seven. The White Lotus sect of 12th century China practiced what religion? And the White Lotus is set at a resort in what state? And the final question of round six, it's question number eight. Number eight, initials JG, what Fault in Our Stars author also wrote Looking for Alaska? For the second point, initials JG, what Hamilton actor also starred in Looking? Question eight, one more time. Initials JG, what Fault in Our Stars author also wrote Looking for Alaska? And initials JG, what Hamilton actor also starred in Looking? And wouldn't you know it, we've come to the end of the round. That means it's time for another bonus question. Another opportunity to win up to $50 in Taver credit just by typing exclamation point and the answer in chat. And I'm going to tell you, exclamation point and three words, no spaces on this one. And it's not rigged. Bonus question. An 1873 Mark Twain novel and an HBO period piece created by Julian Fellowes share what gold-tinged title? Exclamation point. It is three words. Put them all together. Squish them up. No spaces. Exclamation point and the three-word title in the chat. Do it now! All right, while you guys are putting the answer in the chat, we're going to go over the round six answers. Round six answers, question number one. Number one, a famous historical example of food insecurity was what island's 1840s potato famine? That is Ireland, famously home to a potato famine. Secondly, who co-created and starred in HBO's Insecure? That is Issa Rae. Question number two. Barry Bonds ended his career 65 hits shy of what milestone number? That is 3,000. In the year 3,000. In Barry, Bill Hader plays a hitman living in LA and trying to convert to what legit job? That is acting. Question number three. The first book and first film adaptation of the Oz series was called The What Wizard of Oz? That was The Wonderful Wizard of Oz. Secondly, what Ghostbuster played the warden on Oz? That was the fabulous Ernie Hudson. Would have been really weird if that was Dan Aykroyd. Number four, nicknamed Le Roi Soleil, what long-lived king was succeeded by his great-grandson? That is Louis the 14th. Assuming I did those Roman numerals correctly. The Roy family on Succession is led by what long-lived patriarch? That is Logan. Logan Roy is his name on Succession. Has anyone watched Succession? Someone has. What Philadelphia University is the home of the Dragons? That is Drexel. Drexel University. Secondly, the upcoming House of the Dragon is about what inbred Westerosi family? That is the Targaryens. Oh, those Targaryens. Also, HBO, really trying it one more time. That's what they're going with. Number six in round six. One of the most famous opera roles for soprano Leontine Price was what Ethiopian princess? That is Aida. And secondly, on The Sopranos, which character owned and operated the Bada Bing strip club? That was Silvio Dante. Don't eat the gabagool at the Mob Run strip club. Number seven. The White Lotus sect of 12th century China practiced what religion? That is Buddhism. Secondly, the White Lotus is set at a resort in what state? That is Hawaii. And the last question of round six, question number eight. Number eight. Initials JG, what Fault in Our Stars author also wrote Looking for Alaska? That is John Green. And secondly, initials JG, what Hamilton actor also starred in Looking? And that was Jonathan Groff. Jonathan Groff. Back to our bonus question. Round six bonus question. An 1873 Mark Twain novel and an HBO period piece created by Julian Fellowes share what gold-tinged title? That is The Gilded Age. It's time for round number seven. It's the final round, random knowledge. Last time I hosted this, I remember it being a little bit later in the evening, but I don't remember what happened since then.
Can you dig it?
Round seven, random knowledge, our final round of the night, no matter what people in the chat say. 16 possible points. Some questions are going to have a couple multiple parts and maybe worth multiple points. I'll let you know, but pay attention. This is on you. Question number one. Number one. Please don't take my banana. An Oregon zoo orangutan with flaming locks of auburn hair was recently named for what Dolly Parton song? Number one, please don't take my banana. An Oregon zoo orangutan with flaming locks of auburn hair was recently named for what Dolly Parton song? Great Combo. Great Combo in chat said, have you met the orangutan 9 to 5? He's here all day. Question number two is worth 2 points. 2 points. In the NBA conference semifinals, Boston and Golden State knocked out what two middle-of-the-country teams from middle-of-the-alphabet cities? 2 points. In the NBA conference semifinals, Boston and Golden State knocked out what two middle-of-the-country teams from middle-of-the-alphabet cities? Final round, random knowledge, 16 possible points on the line. We're on question three. Number three, Beanie Feldstein was recently snubbed of a Tony nod for her role as Fanny Bryce in what revived musical that anagrams to Flying Urn? Number three, Beanie Feldstein was recently snubbed of a Tony nod for her role as Fanny Bryce in what revived musical that anagrams to Flying Urn? Question number four in our last round. Question four, it's worth 3 points. For 3 points, I'll name a nation, you name a country it borders that starts with the next letter in the alphabet. So, for example, if I said Guatemala, the answer would be Honduras. Hopefully that example makes sense. If it doesn't, the points don't matter. It's the internet. Just lie at the end of the night and say you got 1,000,000 points in the final round. First up, we have Syria, then Romania, and lastly, Bolivia. Again, I've named a nation. You next need to name a country that it borders that starts with the next letter in the alphabet. We've got Syria, Romania, and Bolivia. On a question five in our last round of the evening. Number five. A pair of cousins recently lost their pilot licenses after a dumb failed mid-air plane swap stunt that was predictably sponsored by what beverage brand? I feel dumber just for reading that. A pair of cousins recently lost their pilot licenses after a dumb failed mid-air plane swap stunt that was predictably sponsored by what beverage brand? Question number six in our last round. Number six. 3 points. I'm going to give you a quick description and a year. You name each island movie. First up. Slacker Pete Davidson in 2020. Second. Pirate Gina Davis in 1995. And thirdly, insane U.S. Marshal Leo DiCaprio in 2010. Again, for all of these, you name each island movie. First up, Slacker Pete Davidson in 2020. Secondly, Pirate Gina Davis in 1995. And thirdly, insane U.S. Marshal Leonardo DiCaprio in 2010. Oh no, the chat started on Obi-Wan Kenobi. Don't. I have been religiously watching live feeds of Star Wars Celebration for the past 4 days. And I am excited. All right, question number seven. Our penultimate question of the night. Number seven. A decade before Stonewall, the similar Cooper Donuts uprising went down in what West Coast city's Bunker Hill neighborhood? Number seven, a decade before Stonewall, the similar Cooper Donuts uprising went down in what West Coast city's Bunker Hill neighborhood? And the last question of the last round, question number eight. Question number eight, you guessed it, is worth 4 points. For 4 points, tell me, is it an entry in the 2022 Eurovision Song Contest or the name of a David Sedaris book? Is it an entry in the 2022 Eurovision Song Contest or a name of a David Sedaris book? First up, Eat Your Salad. Secondly, Dress Your Family in Corduroy and Denim. Thirdly, Me Talk Pretty One Day. And lastly, Give That Wolf a Banana. Tell me, for each of these, is it an entry in the 2022 Eurovision Song Contest or the name of a David Sedaris book? Eat Your Salad, Dress Your Family in Corduroy and Denim, me talk pretty one day, give that wolf a banana. Also, if you've ever had an opportunity to see David Sedaris talk in person, either about one of his books or just in general, you should do that because he's fantastic. All right, that is the end of the round. That means it's time for one last bonus question of the night. Maybe, if it wasn't before, it is now rigged in your favor. Exclamation point and the answer in chat, and hopefully you'll win our bonus question. Bonus question. Russia's most recent arch nemesis is what fast food chain that's selling off all 800 plus of its stores in the country? Exclamation point and the answer in chat. And hopefully the system is rigged in your favor. Or again, Cash App AJ. All right, while you're putting the bonus in the chat, we'll go over the answers to our final round, round seven. Here is question number one. Number one, please don't take my banana. An Oregon Zoo orangutan with flaming locks of auburn hair was recently named for what Dolly Parton song? It is, of course, Jolene, the orangutan. Number two. In the NBA Conference semifinals, Boston and Golden State knocked out what two middle-of-the-country teams from middle-of-the-alphabet cities? They are the Memphis Grizzlies and the Milwaukee Bucks. Question number three. Number three. Beanie Feldstein was recently snubbed of a Tony nod for her role as Fanny Bryce in what revived musical that anagrams to Flying Urn? That is Funny Girl. Final round, question four. Question four was 3 points in which I named a nation and you named a country it borders that starts with the next letter in the alphabet. First up, we had Syria, and following them is Turkey. The second one was Romania, and the country next is Serbia. And lastly, we had Bolivia, and following them is Chile. Question number five. Number five. A pair of cousins recently lost their pilot licenses after a dumb failed mid-air plane swap stunt that was predictably sponsored by what beverage brand? That is Red Bull. Red Bull, how could you? You were better than that. Number six. 3 points. I gave you a quick description and a year, and you had to name each island movie. First up, slacker Pete Davidson in 2020. That was The King of Staten Island. Secondly, we had Pirate Gina Davis in 1995. That was Cutthroat Island. Do you guys remember Cutthroat Island? It was not a very good movie. And lastly, insane U.S. Marshal Leonardo DiCaprio in 2010. And that was, of course, Shutter Island, which was a fantastic movie. Russian Robert says Red Bull sucks. I agree. It's not that great. Question number seven. Number seven. A decade before Stonewall, the similar Cooper Donuts uprising went down in what West Coast city's Bunker Hill neighborhood? That was Los Angeles. Jerfad rightly pointing out that Cutthroat Island did destroy the studio that made it. Yeah, rightly so. People greenlit that. You shouldn't have. Number eight, 4 points. Is it an entry in the 2022 Eurovision Song Contest or the name of a David Sedaris book? Eat Your Salad? That is a song from Eurovision. I haven't heard that one yet, but I'm going to look it up later. Secondly, dress your family in corduroy and denim. That is a David Sedaris book. Thirdly, Me Talk Pretty One Day. That one, also a David Sedaris book. And lastly, Give That Wolf a Banana. That is a Eurovision song. That one, I watched that one. I saw Give That Wolf a Banana. It is fantastic. Eat Your Salad, I am being told very aggressively in chat, I need to listen to. And I will. I will listen to it when I'm not on the air and we won't get dinged for playing copyrighted salad music. Bonus question time. Our last chance to rig the votes in someone's favor. The winner, or the question itself. Russia's most recent arch nemesis is what fast food chain selling off all 800 plus of its stores in the country? That fast food chain is McDonald's. Geeks Who Drink, we're all over the place. We are back in bars. Go, exclamation point, find us in the chat. Find the quiz nearest you. If you are in Denver, Colorado this weekend, come find me at the Weird Al concert, because that's where I'll be. Because I'm a nerd. Duh. Thank you guys so much for coming out tonight. Penelope is, she's gone. She ate her fish treats and took off. But thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of your Memorial Day. Come see us at quiz nights all over the place. And thanks for quizzing.